All right, everybody. Back to building a little bit more on this cooker I've been building. Worked at it a little bit. Actually burnt my hand by being lax on safety equipment. And you've seen me wear all kinds of safety equipment in these videos, but it was cool the other morning about 2 weeks ago on a Thursday. And I was grinding this door frame out that I put on the side of this firebox. And I was, I wasn't putting my glove on to do the grinding of a couple small welds. I got in a hurry, I guess, and grinded one side of the firebox door to smooth out the welds so I could make this seamless. I'll show you this here in a minute, but then I rotated the firebox door to do the other side and grind down the weld so it looks seamless. And so when I rotated it to hold it in place, I put my hand right down on the spot I just finished grinding. So I think the worst burn I've ever had. I burned my palm about an egg size. I went about an hour and a half in pretty well good pain and decided to go to urgent care. Well, they did give me some cream, gave it a good wrap, and gave me a tetanus shot, and I think something like an anti-inflammatory. So I'm glad for that, but then I wasn't able to really work on it too much after that for a few days. Man, that cream, Silverdyne or something like that, Silverdyne, that stuff, that sure did help. So if anybody ever gets burnt, go ahead, go to urgent care. They kind of have a good remedy for it. So I wish I didn't wait an hour and a half of probably one of the worst things, like consistent pains that I've had in a long time. So anyways, I did get back to it a little bit here and there. So I'm going to show you what I got going on here. Here's the grill. What I've been doing was working on the firebox door. I had some stuff done, as we saw previously. I had the firebox done, smokestack. Oh, I don't know that I mentioned that I had completed the stack pipe flue, whatever you want to call that, damper. This thing kind of gave me a pain in the butt. I did one other one and didn't have a problem. I didn't know if it's because these were shorter. I didn't want to waste material. I'm trying to learn how to use just enough material to get the job done. So what happened was it bound up. It wouldn't rotate. So I ended up having to just cut a seam here and split it apart a little bit more because the inner diameter of the tube here was about the same as this, which can be kind of nice for tight hinges. And that may be the problem that I had before. I may need to just pay attention, may try to give a little bit more leeway in there or grind these inner posts or these inside swivel points, grind them a little bit more skinny. Because when I got it in here, it wouldn't rotate. And then actually, as I'm doing this hinge over here, I'm realizing that another thing is that when metal gets hot, it expands. So maybe if I had waited, it might've cooled down and rotated, which, I mean, I waited a little bit, but maybe if I had waited overnight and just seen how well it would operate after it cooled down. But you can see I tried to go back and grind that a little bit. I can rotate it up and down some. So I kind of tried to clean up the shaft so it would rotate smoothly. But I got it where it moves. I kind of like it because this part hits this part of the tube so that when I go to close it, it doesn't go any further than that. It's all closed up, but it's a nice stopping point. So open, close, so kind of cool. I tried to seal that gap. I don't think it's necessarily important. It sure stops the flow of air at that rate. I mean, my purchased barbecues never had a tremendously wonderful seal up there. The idea is to just stop the flow of air, either when you're done or to minimize it a little bit while you're cooking. So it's working good. Looks pretty cool. Again, I already discuss the greats. I did make that one shorter so I could get to the meat on the bottom rack, right? So instead of losing that space, I mean, yeah, the grate was longer. I had more space up here, but this is gonna be better. This is still pretty big, so not too bad, not too small. A lot of good cooking space on here. But the most recent was doing this side here of the firebox. Had this idea with the door latch, so I can move that over. And so this here extends out, and actually, I added the washer there so that I'm able to keep it kind of tighter. So when I close it and I push that in, it's a snug close. Sorry, doing everything one-handed while holding a phone to record is super easy, right? I also made this so I can open that up as much or as little as I like. That worked out pretty good. Some of the follies, I should say, on that door right there was when I went to weld the rails for that slide for that firebox damper, I welded it completely. I had put a bead of weld all the way across this thing here and even down here, all the way across. Well, then it warped my door, right? This isn't super tremendous thick metal. It's relatively thin. So the heat across the whole thing had the door warped. So I had to cut them off and kind of get the door back into shape. And then I actually welded these on the backside first, just tack welds. I'm learning that the value of tack welds like that, or yeah, tacking it up, is that you don't apply so much heat to the metal to warp it. So anyways, there's this expanded metal to create this kind of screen. I thought it kind of looked cool. This here, I actually, when I went to drill this out and cut it, I didn't mark it just right so that I got only inside this square tube. So I actually end up leaving a little gap, and I didn't want any heat or air to leak out anywhere I didn't really want it. Wouldn't have been tremendously negatively affecting it, but so I had to weld that in. And then I didn't have my welding just right, so I burnt a couple holes. I ended up having to backfill and weld. I kind of grinded it down smoother just so it wasn't big ugly welds, but it's sealed now. This light's relatively easy. I'm gonna get it painted up, and I may go ahead and, you know, get some oil in there. We'll see what happens, how well that maintains sliding. May take some cleaning up once in a while, but yeah, not too bad. I did this kind of hinge design over here because I ran out of space to put this kind of hinge. So not too bad. I got that barrel style hinge there. And so it's working good. I did, so what I found when I first just welded this a little bit ago, it didn't want to move easy, even though it moved easy after I tacked it. I tacked all three parts on, and it opened and closed smoothly. So I was like, all right, that's gonna work. And then I did the more significant welds here and here, and then I wanted to be a little bit stiff. So I did polish up these, kind of grind it down. Seems like this door is kind of biting here. This one's the one not moving with the door. These two are. So you can kind of see that gap now closes up on that. You can see right here where it's scraping. So I'll see if I can't smooth that down with a grinder and let it open and close a lot more smoothly. But opens real smooth. Opens real smooth, but it kind of bites there a little bit. So I'll get that taken care of. But pretty cool door. I'm excited about this thing. I hope it sells because I want to recoup some of the costs. But at the same time, I'm ready to cook on this thing. I got some more. I think I do want to go ahead and put a door up here, because as I was cooking on my cooker recently, I like the value of being able to open that up and situate the wood or add wood and then close it back down. I also want to maybe go ahead and put a grate in there So it can be, you can grill on it or whatever. So I think that'll be next, cutting and mounting and framing a door on here. I got hinges and handle parts already ready. So that'll be probably next. And then I do want to do, probably use that expanded metal. I do want to do some sort of a shelf off the front of this. So we'll see how much I can get of that done over the next week or so, but and finally get this with a coat of paint on and finished someday. But looking pretty cool. Keep up. We'll see what's next. Thanks for watching.